In this part of the class, we are going to discuss ALM. Remember that you are writing test cases, right? If you work as a manual tester, okay, if you work as a manual tester, your primary job will be writing test cases, executing test cases, and reporting defect. If you work as a manual tester, right? Understanding requirements, right? Analyzing requirements. And from those requirements, writing test cases, and when the application is built, you will be testing those test cases, those you have written, and then if there is a defect, you will be reporting the defects, right? So if you work as a manual tester, that is your core responsibility. Now, your core responsibility, the way it happens in the organization, big or small, every organization will use some tool to for this purpose, writing test cases, executing test cases, and reporting defect, right? Issue tracking, they will be using a tool. One of the tool that is very popular is ALM, Application Lifecycle Management. The previous name of ALM was Quality Center, HP Quality Center, right? So HP Quality Center, the new version, the name is the name of the new version is Application Lifecycle Management. Okay, Application Lifecycle Management. So this Application Lifecycle Management, right? As you can see that now it is Micro Focus Lifecycle Management. So previously the tool was owned by HP, but at this point this tool is owned by Micro Focus. They have purchased that tool. It's an expensive tool. You know, it cost pretty decent amount of money to buy the license to use it. So I have this trial version from where I'm going to share how in the organization they use this tool. We will have a few classes on this, but today we are going to have some basic ideas. I will let you know what you will need to do. You have already written few test cases using in the Word document, right? So now I will show you this test cases, right? How you gonna write it in ALM. Okay, let me add him again. I'm not sure he's having issue in to remain in this call. Just give me 1 second. Okay, Raja bhai, can you hear me? Okay, no problem. So that tool, I sent you invitation to few of you. So let me go back to this tool and let me bring few of the things from the tool. So let's say that I have created a trial version of this tool. So that tool, I was trying to bring this tool for a long time, and finally it is here in the tool. So let me just quickly do this. So if I go to this Micro Focus, right, in box, and then if you come all the way to this, I have it here, Micro Focus, right? So if I go to this continue, and then from here I sent a few of them. I sent you invitation already, but let me see what happens here.
Open that link, it says expired now, but I did confirm it earlier.
You confirmed it earlier, let me see. I'll have to send you another invitation probably. Let me send you an invitation. Okay. Naved, can you tell me your email address? naved.99@gmail.com. Now can you try Naved? Let me see what happens. Did you get it, Naved? And your email is IPA00004. I'm looking at another screen at Gmail, right? gmail.com. I have already, probably you already, you are already there. I'll check it. Naved, are you able to accept it?
It's email signed.
And Sharmin, do you have a Gmail address?
BIBI.
One second, Sharmin. So it is BIBI. Gmail.com, right? Let me see. And can you see if you are able to there? And then, Razabai, do you have a Gmail address? What is that Gmail address? Mm-hmm. 07. Then, did I send invitation to everyone? You didn't receive the email now. Okay, go ahead. Naved K. @gmail.com. Looks good. Already exists. Navedk91@gmail.com. These user already exist. Now let me take a look what is happening here.
Yeah, I didn't receive the email yet.
You didn't receive any email yet? I'll check. Give me a second. So here, let me see, test spaces.
Last time I received, and when I confirmed it, it was okay. Now it says the verification link has expired.
Okay, 1 second. Spaces. So let's say that Navid Navid k91@gmail.com, and then let's say you do not need phone number here, English and role. Let's say you are a tester, right? Add and another. So it is complaining what? Your phone number, right? Let's put a dummy phone number here. Okay, now can you see if you have received anything in the email, Navid? Did you receive anything? Not yet. Okay, we'll take care of this user part later. Now let's say that this user guest tester, then okay. So normally what happens, guys, for your organization, if they are using this ALM tool, they you will get something like this, right? You will get something like this, a URL. Can you see this URL? You will get a URL like this, and then you will be able to log in. Once you go to this URL, right? Once you go to this URL, it will look like... let me show you something. Okay. So once you go to this URL, it will look like this. Login, you are able to bring that tool.
My account, lunch, 29 days left.
Lunch there, go there. When you go there, what do you see? So that means you are able to go there by your other email, right? Okay, that's fine. Now, Sharmin, have you received anything after that? Nipa, were you able to get anything in the mail? Okay. So, Sharmini, if you can tell me your email address again.
BIBIAMANA
at, is there anything else? 18. BIBIAMANA 18. A user with this email already exists. So it seems like I already have you in the system. So you should be able to, you should be receiving an email to confirm, but you will get it. Hopefully you'll be getting it soon. Okay. So I can include 20 people who can work on this. Okay. Now, I already have invitation to all of you. You should be able to check your email, including your spam folder, and confirm it before the link expires, and then you'll be able to use it. And if you cannot use it, you can get your own trial version, like my one, right? How you can get it? So if you type here ALM Octane trial version, right? Can you see this ALM Octane trial version? Can you see this link? You will have to fill up your information here. Welcome. So this is, since I am already logged in, that's why it is bringing my account, but you will be able to, if you follow this URL, right, you will be able to get your own trial version for a month, or let's say for 40 days by registering there. So what happens once you put your information there, they will be sending you an email to confirm your email. You click on it, your email will be confirmed, and then from that point it will take a couple of days for them to finally approve it, so that you can get a trial version like me for a month or so. You got it? So make sure that you have created your own trial version as well, so that you can do whatever you like as an admin. Okay, now, so what you can do in this tool, right? What you can do in this tool as a tester, what is your role in this tool? So we'll be discussing few of the features for, let's say, half an hour or so. So if you go there, right, if you go there in this tool, in this workspace, right, you will see that if you get out of these settings, right, you'll be in the default space. Now, can you see this management? There is a menu here. Now you take a look here. There are requirements tab, there are backlog tab, there are team backlog tab, there are quality tab, right? Can you see? As a tester, basically you will be using this quality tab. Okay, when you are a tester, you will be using this quality tab. Backlog, requirements, all of these things will be handled by the BAs or project management. All of these things, they will be putting the requirements and backlogs here for every sprint. Everything will be here, they will be putting it, right? You will be reading these requirements from here. You will be analyzing the requirements from here, analyzing the backlog, team backlog from here. And then your job is to create test and execute test. Your job is to create defects, right? This is the quality tab. That is what you are going to use. Now, let's say we are discussing here ALM, right? Let's say many of the organization, you will see they will be using TFS. So similar, there will be similar thing for your testing. There will be a module. Okay, so let's say someone is using Jira, there will be something similar. So function wise there will be similar functionality. It will be like UI wise it will be here and there. They might be doing it in a different way, but same thing. There will be requirements where people will be adding all of the requirements for you, all of the backlogs for you, right? This backlog, what does this backlog means? This backlog means, like, when you start, like, remember we have discussed agile scrum software development methodology, right? So backlog means, like, when you start a sprint, what are the item of work that developers have identified they are going to do? These are the backlog. Okay, now, so the requirements and this backlog, these are to be taken care of by the by your development team, by your BAs, by your team management team. Your activity is on the quality tab, where you write test cases, you execute test cases, you report defects. Does it make sense? What is your role in this application lifecycle management tool? Okay. Now, let's say that we have a requirement, right? We already have studied a requirement by where, by using which we were writing our test cases, right? Let's say, what is our requirement? Our requirement was here. What is the requirement document? I'm trying to open it. So this is the requirement document, right? That we were discussing. So this requirement will be already in the tool for you to study, for you to read, right? So here, if you take a look at this requirement, you will be reading the requirement, you will be analyzing. If you have any question, you will be asking question to people to understand more about the requirement. And once your analyzing is done, you have understood the requirement, you will be start writing your test cases, right? Let's say that we have a functionality, right? We have a functionality, let's say that user registration, right? There is a functionality in the website, let's say user registration, and you'll have to write a test case for this registration functionality, right? So how will you write the test case? Now you have the requirement, you have read the requirement that you need to write a test case for that. Now how will you handle this, right? You will be going to your test module. Okay, now here, can you see there is we are in the test tab, and then can you see there is a manual test? You click on this, and then let's say, what is your test case name? Let's say you are writing, okay, user registration. User registration, right? And then what is that for? Let's say this is for end-to-end, this is for regression, right? This is for security. You select the features, why this test case is for. And then estimated duration, minute, how long will it take for a user to test this feature, right? Let's say I'm going to say 5 minutes, okay? And backlog coverage. Now remember that those people will be putting the backlog for you, right? Backlog means, okay, this is the requirement, or this is the feature they have included in the sprint, right? So you put this, you select a backlog from here. I do not have a backlog from here, but you will be able to associate a backlog here for this particular test case, right? And then application module, right? There will be multiple module. Let's say user registration, there is a flight itinerary, there is hotel booking, right? So all of this module, you can associate this to a particular module. And then description, right? What is this test case about? You put a simple text, okay? This test case is to verify the user. This test case is to verify the user registration process works as expected. Okay, and then you say add or add and edit. Now if I select add and edit, okay, now I have, that is the panel where I'm going to write my test case, right? First step, remember, what do you have? Your first step is your action, right? To do this, I do not have the requirement in details here. If you take a look at this requirement, they didn't talk about this registration feature probably. Oh yeah, the user will be able to create his or her login information in order to make reservations, right? So this register is there. They didn't put any details. Remember, this is a very brief requirement, and it doesn't have all the information. So we will write this, whatever we understood from this. But normally, if you want to register on something, you know what information to put, right? But in the real world field for registration, there will be more specification, like what type of information you need to put there. Okay, now we are going to write this test case for our purpose here. So first of all is open a browser and navigate to new course.demoaut.com. okay, now this is your action. Now when you do this action, what will happen? Can you see add a validation step, right? You write here what do you expect, right? So here your expectation will be, let's say that web page will be loaded, right? Register link will be displayed in the top navigation bar, or let's say in the horizontal navigation bar. Okay, and then add. So this is our action and expected results. We put the expected results. Number one is our action, number two is our expected results, and then you do add another step. Next step is click on the register link, and then what is that validation step, right? User registration page will be open, right? And then you add another step. Next step is input all the necessary information. I do not know what those information, I'm trying to make it brief, right? Input all the necessary information for user registration and submit, right? What is the expectation? Here you expect, okay, a successful, okay, let's say that user registration successful message will be displayed, right? That's all your test case, right? Now you save. Now I already have, if you go back to your here, I already have a test case for new tours login, so I'm not going to write another test case. Let's say that now, how do you execute this test case, right? So see, let's say that you have already written all of your test cases. Now the application is ready, the developers have developed the features. Now you are a tester. Now your responsibility, let's say that, can you see that your team lead or team member can assign test cases to you. Okay, these test cases are assigned to you for your execution. Let's say you have 100 test cases, you got the responsibility to execute 25 test cases. So you will see that a team lead can associate these test cases for you. Okay, now let's say that you got responsibility to execute these two test cases, 2001 and 1003. You select these two test cases, and then can you see run button here, right? Now obviously you have to click on this run button. When you click on this run button, remember it will be asking, okay, what is the release, right? Let's say our planned release is in February 2020. So if you guys, let me tell you this, note this, okay? Let's say that if when you try to execute, you cannot execute without selecting this release. So sometimes, right, now when you create a new instance, right, if you request for a new instance from ALM, this release will not be here, right? So how do you create release? So there are a lot of helps available. You type here how to create a release in ALM Octane. Click on it, and then can you see, if you click here, you will see all the step, like what you need to do to create a release, right? You just create a release by following the instruction here, then you will be able to execute your test cases. Does it make sense? Okay, so run name, let's give a run name, user registration and login. User registration and login. And what is the sprint? Remember, we have discussed agile methodology, software development methodology, where that they develop a plan, like out of, let's say, 20 requirements, they will be doing 6 requirements in sprint 1, and 6 requirements in sprint 2, and then another 8 requirements in sprint 3. So let's say we are in sprint 1, where they are working on the first requirements. Okay, and milestone, if there is any milestone, again, project management can add a milestone there. If there is any milestone, you'll be seeing it here. Okay, now at this point, let's say we do not have any milestone. Now, where are you executing this? Let's say you are, remember, we have discussed development environment, production environment, QA environment, right? We are going to execute this in the QA environment. Now, after selecting the environment, say okay, and then let's run. Now, when you are running this test case, right? Now, can you see, you have first test case is new to login, right? But you cannot do a login before you do a user registration. So I'm going to execute the next one, right? Can you see, actually for login, I have two execution. I'll tell you why I have click on register. Okay, this is for registration, right? This test case is for registration. So according to the test case, what are they asking? Open browser and navigate to newtools.demoaot.com. So typically in your work, you will have three screens. I have three screens, three monitors, right? I keep my step that I need to follow in one monitor, and I open the browser in another monitor, right? In that way, I can keep my steps, and then I can browse parallelly, right? So here, I'm going to say newtools.demoaot.com. So when I open the application, was it able to open me the application? Yeah, it was able to open the application successfully, right? So what I'm going to do here, I was successfully able to open the application. So my validation step here, can you see this? This is the validation step. So when I open the browser, and I was able to open the application. So what I'm going to do, remember, you are doing whatever a manual tester does normally at work. That's it. So you select here, it is passed. Right? Step one, passed. If you want to keep any comment, you can keep the comment here. I do not need to keep a comment here. Okay. Next step, click on register link. When you click on register link, you should see user registration page will be open, right? Now let me go to the application, click on register link. Now user registration page is open, right? Can everyone see this? Okay.
The real life website is also the present.
Yeah. If you want to if you have to test it, the website will have to be there.
Okay.
Right, remember, when you are writing your test case, the website is not there. But you test the website once the website is ready.
Okay.
Now you come here. So when I click on register link, it was able to open the application for me. So I'm going to say pass. Okay. Then input the necessary information for registration and click submit. Right. Let's do this step. Now here, let's say I'm going to put Mr. First, right? Last name. Okay. And then phone number, let's put something. Okay. And email address, let's say test at. Can everyone hear me?
Yeah.
Rajabhai, can you hear me? Oh, he's again dropped. he sent a text. That's why he had this. Rajabhai, what is happening to your connection? Okay, all right. Can you see now? Okay. So here, user registration, right? We are doing this registration part. So it is asking, okay, input user information for registration and submit, right? So when I submit, I should see a successful message. Let me do this. So I am in the application here. So I put information, let's say that, okay, this is the address and then username, right? Remember this username. So what is your favorite username? Let me put a username here. Huh? Auto one, right? And what is your password? Let's keep the password simple as well. What password do you want to put? Test 1 2 3 4 5, right? Test 1 2 3 4 5, submit, right? Now did we get a successful message? Thank you for studying. We got it, right? Your username is auto one, so that means it is successful, right? So you go there in your execution, you mark this step as test. Got it? So that is test case 2 is passed all the way, right? If you want to keep any note, yeah, I was successfully to register auto one user with a password. What is the password? What is the password? Test 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? Okay. This test case is done. Now you come back to the login one. So you will see that your information will remain there. All of the information that you have done will be there. Now you have one more test case to go. Now, again, you will have to log in. Right? To log in, you will have to, let's say, again, right? You will have to open the application, right? So according to the test case, what is you will have to do? Open browser and navigate to newtours.demo.aot.com, right? So again, you do newtours.demo.aot.com. So the page loaded successfully, right? So let me mark this over there as a pass. And then input username, right? Let me go there and input username. Normally, as I said, like you have more than one monitor, you keep your step in one screen and you keep your application in another screen. So here, what is our username? Auto one. And when I input auto one, it is displayed here in the username text box, right? Now you go there. So when you input the username, what is your expectation? Username will be displayed in the text box. We saw that username was displayed in the text box. And then let me go there. What is the next step? Input password. And what is my expectation? Password will be displayed as encrypted, right? So there is a problem in this step. Can you see I have put two step in the same click on sign in button, right? I did a verification point for this. The click in sign in button, right? So I put this one in a validation step, but that's fine. Password, when I input the password, password will be displayed encrypted. Now what is the password? TEST 1 2 3 4, right? And password is not displayed, so we are good here. Let me mark this step as passed. And then when you are clicking in sign in button, login successful message will be displayed, right? Now you go there in the application, click on sign in. Now was my login successful? No. Can you see it didn't give me the home page, instead it gave me the login page again. That means I was not able to successfully log in, right? So there is a bug here, right? I cannot log in for a good user, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a screenshot of this. right? So I'm going to bring my snipping tool, and then when I have submitted my login, what did I got? I got this, right? I got this. I didn't get a success message, and instead it presented the login page again. So what I'm going to do here, right? I'll be going to my execution, right? Here, login successful, right? It is not passed. I'm going to fail it. I'm going to put a comment here. I was not to log in, right? Now, can you see this add a defect? Right? Click on add a defect. Now, you'll be able to add a defect. Now, whenever you see something is not working as expected, your responsibility as a tester to speak up. How do you speak up? You speak up by reporting a defect. Okay. Now we are reporting a defect or bug. So what is the bug name? Right. Login failed for valid username and password. Okay. And then what is the backlog? Remember, if you want to associate with a backlog, you will be able to. And then what is the severity of the defect? If the login is not working, it is very high. The severity is very high. And what is the application? Again, you will be able to select the application. And what is the story point? If there is a story point that you want to associate, you will be able to associate. And then you will be able to associate a release with it. And then, right, remember, you can assign the defect to someone, right? So you will see all of the teams where you need to assign this defect. You will be able to select, okay, who are you? Try to send this defect to. You'll be able to select people from here, and then you come here, defect type, pre-release, and then environment, QA, we know. Now you come to the description, right? Now in the description, right, you say what the summary of the defect, right? So you say that the login was not working for me for a valid name and password. And when I submitted my login, I got the following error message. And what is the error message? You paste the screenshot here. Is it clear? Yeah, you can do attachment. If you have more than one screenshot, you do attachment, you can put your screenshot here too. Okay, and then can you see task to regenerate the bug? Now you'll have to put the steps that they need to do to recreate the bug. So in this case, yeah, open application by going to newtours.demo.aut.com and then login by user name auto 1 password. What is the password? S 1 2 3 4 5, right? And then number 3, click on submit button, right? That's it. Like, it is a simple way to straightforward way to regenerate the bug. Sometimes you'll see the way is complicated and you need to provide the steps in detail. So whoever is going to test, they need to know how to recreate the issue. So task to regenerate will list all of the steps that you need to do to recreate the issue. Does it make sense? So when you report a defect, right, can you see? First of all, you will have to select some header fields, like what is the priority, what is the severity, who are you going to assign it to, what was the release, what was the environment. Right, let's say if you do not put the environment, there are multiple environment, QA environment, development environment, right? where they will go to test this defect. You need to say what environment it is, and then you say what is the summary of the defect, including the screenshot. You can, if you want to attach anything, right, you can attach by clicking here. By you can attach image, you can attach anything, right, from here. You can attach, so these options are here, and then say how to recreate, and then you say add. Do you have any question up to this, how to create a defect and what is defect? Any question, guys? Okay, so now if you click add, right, and then can you see in the defect tab you have added defect, right? You have added a defect and you have already put comment, everything. Now you have executed both of the test cases. This is the first one, this is the second one, right? Everything is done. Your one test case passed, one test case failed. Now your execution is done. So you say stop run because your execution is done. Okay, now if you come here, right, you will see that can you see this test case positive login, right? Last run, this is the result. Last run, one require attention, that means there is a defect, one defect here, right? And then can you see this test case last run, it passed, one passed. Can you see last run what happened here? One require attention. Okay, now what is happening, guys? Oh, one thing that we didn't do here, right? If you go to this let's say that let's come to this test again.
Manually.
Yeah, this is manually. You are testing manually. When you test manually, that is how you test. Okay. Now, let's say that if you go back, let's say test, and then if you particularly go there, let's say this was the test case that failed, right? If you go to this test case, right? And if you come to this runs, can you see? If you come to this runs, right? Can you see we did an execution today, 126, right? Can you see sprint one and then it failed here, right? Can you see this? Right? Guys, can you see? And then if you go to this runs details, right? Go there. Now, you will be able to see like every of it, I was not able to log in, right? And can you see there is a defect here with that?
Right?
One defect, right? You will be able to see all of the details. Whatever executions you do, all the details will be here in test run step. Does it make sense? So you have created a defect for validation steps, and you will be able to. How do you go to the defect? If you want to see this defect, you come here, click on here, and you will be able to see the detail of that defect. Can you see all the details here? The login was not working for me, valid username and password. And then if you come all the, if you see like all of the details are here. And then how to recreate, where is the step, how to recreate? So now if you want to select someone, right? Can you see I have Nabed? If you want to select someone, okay, Nabed, you work on it, you will be able to select that person. Now that is how. So what we did today, we have created test cases here, we have executed the test cases, we have reported the test cases. Now let's say that later on someone worked on the defect, right? Someone worked on the defect and they want to send it back to you. Now they will be changing, okay, I have reported. They will be selecting me as the owner, and I'll get a notification, hey, this defect is fixed, and then I'll be coming here and retesting. Does it make sense? Okay, so do you have any question up to this, what we did? What, Abed, can you summarize what you did today in that manual testing part? Mm-hmm. We have written test cases here. We have written test cases, and then executed the test cases in ALM, and also we have reported a defect, right? So if you work as a manual tester, that is what you do. Write test cases, execute it, and report defect. Oh, sure. So that is where, like, if you from here, if you go to your test tab, right, that is where you click on manual test, and then you will be able to create the test. You want me to create another one to show you? Test 3. Let me do this, Nandit, and add and edit. Now this is my test. So first of all, this is your step, right? Open browser and navigate to whatever, right? And then add validation step.
One step.
Now let me show you one other thing before I, let's say we are writing another test case. That test case is for, let's say that, remember that you will have to, you can book flights from here, right? So now to book flight, first of all, you will have to sign in, and then you can book flight. Now, can you see if I sign off, right? And if I go to flights, then it will ask me to sign in first, right? Although, remember, can you see auto one? So if you click on flights, what do you see? If you click on flights, it will take you to the sign in page. Is that correct? Now if you sign in auto one, and then test 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and if you click on sign on, now can you see that although I didn't get a successful message that my login is successful, but if you click on flights, oh, it is not taking my login, right? Let me do another. So auto one, and my password is test 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sign in. No, it is not taking. So to book a flight, first of all, you will have to log in. If you do not log in, you will not be able to book a flight. Does it make sense? Okay. So let's say we are writing a test case to book a flight. So what is the first thing? We will have to log in first. Is that correct? Now for login, do I have to write the steps here again? No, I already have a test case for login, right? Now I'm going to say add call step. Can you see this add call step? Click on this, and what call step? Can you see that you have a test case for new tools login, right? Let's say new tools login. This is the test case for login, right? Then you select this, and then you say, where is the button? You say enter. Okay. So, and end-to-end add filter. So, where is my next button? Yeah, this is the one, and then, yeah, okay. This is the test case, right? No, I do not want to go to the test case instead. Let me go back. This is my one. I want to add a call step. And for login, I do not want to write the steps again. So instead, what I want to select this, right? Select this, and then how do I put it there? Not really. No, wait. So here, and then if you press enter. If you click on manual test, okay, if you click, test, where is my, I have a button, I should have a button to add it. Oh, I think I'm missing it. Yeah, click on add, right? Now you'll see that your login, for login, the whole process is there, right? Now you need add another step. What is that another step? After login, The next step will be click on flights tab, from the left navigation bar. What is that? Yeah, for every test case, you will have to open the browser. You will have to log in. Let's say, particularly for this test case where you are booking a flight, you will have to open the browser. You will have to log in. So we already have a test case. That's why I didn't put the step for login again. Instead, I brought the test case from there. And then I started from there. Yeah, browser part, you will see it is already there. We brought it in the login. Remember, in the login, open browser and navigate to new tools demo. It is already there. Right. Now, when you click on flights tab from the left navigation bar, right? Flights selection will be loaded. Right. Let's up to this. For flights, we do not know because we are not able to move forward. So let's say up to this. So this is your test case, and let me change the name for this. This name is book a flight. Okay. Now save it. So this is your test case. Now, if you go to your previous screen, now your test case book a flight, right? Can you see? Book a flight. Now if you run it, right? Let's run. Now, can you see all the steps for login, open application, right? Input username, input password, everything is there. But have you written those steps? No. How did it appear here? Right. We have brought that test case for this particular so that we do not have to write it one more time. Does it make sense? Now you will see after login, click on flight step from the left navigation bar and flight selection will be loaded. Does everything looks okay to you guys? Do you have any question up to this? Anyone, do you have any question? Charmin, Nipa, Razabai, do you have any question? Okay. So once you will be practicing it, Sharmin, Nipa, can you hear me? Okay, I can hear you now. Do you have any question? Raja Bhai, do you have any question, please? Raja Bhai, are you in the call again? Raja Bhai, are you on mute? Raja Bhai, can you hear us? So let's come back to this. So here what is happening, right? Here what is happening, we were able to bring a test case to help another test case without writing the steps for that one, right? Now when you are executing, you can see all of the steps, although you didn't wrote those steps, right? So in that way, you can remember add call step. By that way, you can bring another test case for the help of another one, okay? Does it make sense, everyone?
Yes, after this step, and like, we don't need to do anything here. We just work
in it. No, you will have to, like, to perform this step, you will have to start from 1, 2, 3.
Oh, okay. Because I thought we only
No, you cannot. Without, like, to book a flight, you have to log in first. So you have to complete all of this process. Remember what we did? So when we open browser, it is passing. Right? When you are input username, yeah, it is displaying passed. When you are input password, yeah, it is coming as encrypted. When you are clicking login successful, will be message will be displayed. When you are clicking on login, that is where it is failing. And remember you have a defect already reported. What do you do? Add attachment. Let me see. Please note. Okay. Accept. Let me see. Oh no. We are not attaching, so we can put a note here. This is not working. A defect is already reported. Okay. a defect is already reported on this. What is the defect number? Defect number, let's say we have a defect number. Let me go there. So if you go to the defects tab, right, you will see all the defects, right? This is the defect that we have reported today. Login failed for valid credential, right? Defect 3001. So I'm going to say defect number 3001. You got it? And then definitely you cannot execute this part, right? But it will be you cannot go through. So what you do, right? What you do, can you see overall? You make sure you select failed and then your execution is done.
Severity
is like, if you cannot log in, right, then you cannot do many of the functionalities. So that's why it is very severe. It has highest priority. Got it? So any further question on this, guys? If you do not have any question. Now you select. Can you see severity very high? When you report defect, you will get an option to select this. Any further question? So we have used this test feature to write test cases, and then after writing a test case, we can run it, right? And then after running, if you find any defect, you have reported defect, and then if you want to see all the defects, you come to this defect step. Does it make sense to everyone? So your next step is, if you cannot use the copy that I have created, you create your own copy. You send a request today after this class. Then it will take a couple of days for them to create your trial version. And then you will be able to do all of this stuff like I am doing. Let's say that the video is here, how I have created test cases, how I have created report, right? How I have executed, everything is there. But still, if you are not sure about something, just write here. How to execute test cases in ALM Octane. Okay, you will get details help. Okay, so anything that you want to ask me before, like, so your activities will be immediately after this call, you will be requesting this ALM by going to the link that I have sent you here. Right, can you see? By going to the link, you will be requesting this ALM trial version, and once you get this trial version, whatever we did, your task is whatever 4 or 5 test cases you have written. Remember, you have written 4 or 5 test cases. Bring all of these test cases here and then do execute these test cases and report defect. Is it clear? Once you have created your trial version, then add me by my email address so that I can go there and check your work. Okay, sounds good. Any question? Was it helpful? Was this session helpful, interesting? Everyone liked it? Okay. So, Nipa, Sharmin, what will happen? You will be receiving this email. Sometimes it takes time. That's that ALM process, it takes time. But first of all, what you are going to do, you are going to go to this link, and you are, even if you do not receive your email, you create your own trial version by going to this email, by going to this link here. Right? You want me to send it in the email, or you will be able to get it from the chat from here? Huh? Okay. Yeah, immediately you register, and remember, when you have fill up this information, they will be sending you an email to confirm, and you confirm there. Sometimes that email also takes a little time. So you confirm your email, and then once you have confirmed your email, then it will take a day or two to create the trial version for you. So you make this request as early as possible, and then so that you can get your trial version. And if you are having an issue in getting your trial version, make sure you are letting me know, or you call me. Okay. All right then. So your from me, the expectation to you is all of this database related work you will be submitting, you will be creating your ALM trial version, your own trial version, and then you will be writing all of your test cases there, you will be executing, you will be reporting defect, and you will be adding me to your trial version. Okay. All right, guys. So I wish you like you will be able to do that. And the purpose of this course again, right, to remain in this course, it is very important that you perform these steps. Okay. I'll be very happy if I see you are doing it. If you do not do it, I will be sad, basically. Okay. Nobody want to see me sad, right? So yeah, finish your work. All right.